If you're watching this video, you're most likely looking for how to calculate the age if you have two dates using a spreadsheet. There's lots of different ways to do it if you look around on the internet, but most of them are just more complicated than they need to be. There's a function available in Excel that it's not one of the standard functions. It's only in there because Lotus 1-2-3 had it 25 years ago and they wanted it to be compatible, but it's actually really helpful for doing this. The DATEDIF function works by taking several inputs. The first is the start date, second is the end date, and then the third is the type of units that you want. So if I hit the escape key, this is 17 years. This is using Y as the last parameter. And when I mentioned before that this wasn't a standard function, if you notice, if you type in equals and you type date and then start typing DIF, entire list from below disappears because this isn't listed as standard. It's not going to give you help on it as you type. So when you type DATEDIF and you do the opening parentheses, you're on your own. It doesn't give you any hints. So you have to look at the documentation to see how it works. I have a website. The link is in the upper right hand corner right now. You can click on that to see all these instructions written out for you. We'll go down into the first example, and this is going to show you one, how it works, but also what the different parameters are for the units. It's a little bit confusing. This column's the easiest. It's just counting the number of years, number of total years though. So if it's 17.75, it's just going to give you 7. So if you want the years, months, and the days, you string it together with these three functions. They're all DATEDIF. They're using the same start and end date, but one's a Y, one's a YM, and one's an MD. The YM is saying, all right, I know you already calculated the year, so how many months after the last year that you calculated? And the MD is saying, I know you already have the months, how many days after that last month? So that's why this can work, and it's not saying a couple thousand days there because it knows you already have the months and the days. And then for the last portion of this, I just strung them together with the concatenate function. And this is shorthand for concatenate. I didn't actually write it, but you can also spell out concatenate. This formula does though, it says, give me what's in D14 and add what's in quotes, which is space, years, comma, space, and what's in E14, etc. Concatenating can allow you to output data that looks like a sentence. So let's go a little bit further down and I'll show you how the M and the MD work. So M alone returns the number of months without subtracting the whole years first. So from January 23rd, 99 to 8/28/16 is 211 months, but it's also 5 days. So you'll notice this is the same, this MD is the same function that was used in the first example. It doesn't matter if you also did years. All this is doing is the number of days after the last month. Next example is going to show you how YD works. So if you first calculate the number of years, YD is going to say the number of days elapsed after the last whole year. And this, I think, would be a little bit more rare to use this. I don't know why you're going to say 17 months and 217 days, but I don't know, maybe you are. The last one is just D by itself. All this does is the exact same thing as subtracting the two dates. I did the same formulas here next to each other to show you. So if you do DATEDIF, you do these two fields, start date and end date, you get 6,427. If you subtract the two, you get the same thing. If you're using DATEDIF and you're only using the D parameter, it's probably going to simplify things to just do subtraction. You don't need DATEDIF. But that's pretty much all there is to this function. I don't know why Excel wouldn't have this in their standard list of functions anymore, because it's pretty easy to use. I will tell you there is a warning that the MD function doesn't always work. It can produce errors. keep that in mind. If you're seeing strange behavior, Microsoft knows about it, and there is a workaround on their website. If you search for the DATEDIF function, if you go on the website that I referenced earlier, you can see that Microsoft, the MD, can cause errors, and follow this link and it'll tell you about it. So that's all for now, really, about the DATEDIF function. I hope that was helpful, and leave a comment if you have any questions. Thanks.